Hello. Today I have a little project. My project is to check my siphon valve. It is a valve that is connected to the raw water intake system in the engine. And first you have the seacock, where the water is running up and into the raw seawater filter, and then it takes all the nasty animals and so, and then it is running into the water pump, the little impeller pump I have shown in a other video, and then it is running into the siphon valve, and then from the siphon valve to the engine and through the engine, and then it is cooling the system, the primary cooling system, and then it, the water is running into the exhaust pipe and out of the boat. The problem is, if the valve, the siphon valve, is damaged or don't function, it can result in you are flooding the whole exhaust pipe and the system there. And the problem with that is, when you are flooding the whole system, you can get seawater into your engine, and that is a very bad thing. And in worst case scenario, you can sink your boat. But this valve you must check once in a while. And today I will have a look on my valve. It is a Vetus valve in this boat, but it is a plastic thing. But I know it costs around $100 or something, so I think the quality is okay. But yeah, I'll check it. Here we have the engine, and as you can see, we have the raw seawater pump down there, and the water is running down there and up into the pipe here, and in the top we have the siphon valve, as you can see, the plastic one there, and then it is running down again into the pipe here and into the heat extractor, what do you call it, and then through that and at least into the exhaust pipe, as you can see there, and out of the exhaust pipe. A way you can check your valve is when you are out for sail and the engine is running, you can check if there is coming out water. As you can see, it looks like there has run some water out of the hose from the siphon valve here. That is a clear sign that there is something wrong. When the system is running, you have seawater here in the hoses, and it is running up here and into this valve and down again, but then the two pipes are totally full of seawater. But when you close or turn off the engine, then both pipes must drain slowly, and then the siphon valve must let in some air through the hose here, and the system will then drain. If there's coming out water here, the valve is stuck or something, they're standing in the manual that you must take it apart once in a while, because they can get salt crystals build up in here, and the system will then stuck or break or something. But I will take it apart and check if everything is okay. And as usual, it is very hard to do anything, but I can show you. Put on this screwdriver in the top, and we'll then try to unscrew the system here. It is not that easy to do, as always. When you are fixing anything on a boat, it is a bit hard. As you can see, I can't screw it off with only one hand. Then one of the screws are removed, and I will then remove the last one here, and hopefully open up the system. The screws are very small, as you can see. Yeah. Just a hose, and then we have the valve up here in the top. There is also a small, what do you call it, fetter. Yeah, and a rubber ring here. Yeah, and then the valve itself here. As you can see, yeah, and here we have the valve from the top. As you can see, it is just a small hole where it then let in air when it is needed. And here we have the valve itself. As you can see, it is spring loaded with a little spring, and on the top here there is also a small gasket, rubber gasket, so when it is closed like now, then won't let any fluid get out of the system. And if there's running water out of the pipe here, I can show you. If the valve doesn't work properly, then there will run water back at this hose and down here. But there must only run air through this hose and into the valve, and when the water is getting out of the system, it must suck in air to the valve here, and the water will then go away. I think everything looks great. All the gaskets are very nice, and so I think I will just lubricate the gaskets here with some of this silicone grease, and then I will put the whole thing together again. It's then mounted again here. And as you can see, I have then mounted the rubber gasket, and it is a bit lubricated, and I'll then put on the top again with I think the world's smallest screws. I then tighten the screws again here. This time I have put on some
silicone grease to the screws, so they can be screwed in a bit easier. But still, it is not so easy. And then when the top here compresses, then it is getting the system watertight, and yeah, I think it then it is very good again. Then the screws are tightened up with my little screw thing here, as you can see it from the top. So the gasket is then compressed here, so it is totally watertight.